So, welcome to the Kali Guide. She's a Hindu goddess, probably outsiders might also well known. Yeah, like that. Grab a few items here. Something like that. 20, and then we go over her abilities. She is basically among all assassins a hypercarry. Also, I mean, like, we're talking insane amount of damage, killing you in a matter of not in a split second, but it's just a matter of seconds. It doesn't take long. That is because she has a very high attack speed, very fast attack speed progression, as you can see. Pretty sick. Her passive is called Marked for Death. This is this is a snowball passive, pretty much. You can when you let's leave the fountain again. And let's go back to the fountain. Oh, please. Okay, anyways, you can pick a target. Oh, wait a second. When we spawn the godbots, we may get the pick window again. Because the problem is the target I've chosen, but they are unkillable. As you can see, can't kill the guy here. That's not so bad. We can let's show up the so 6 item Kali, and that is scary as hell.
Well, that's it. Nothing is going to go back to the way it was.
If you're somehow super far ahead, I don't know. Can also build crit. That would at this point not matter at all anymore. Something like this is just in, as I wouldn't usually build this, but
only some of us can be winners. I bet you didn't see that one coming. Guess you don't need my help. Triple kill. 4 in a row. Quadruple. I'll stay out of your way then.
This is just some nonsense build. It's usually not going to happen. I can do it, but I wouldn't recommend it. So anyways, let's go back to her passive. It's called Marked for Death. You kill a god, also you get 10% plus 1% per level penetration against a target you've chosen. When you kill a god, which is your mark, which is marked by you, you get a heal by 80%. And if you just get an assist on your marked target, then you get a 20% heal. So then there's also, this is a snowball effect, gold bounty from that god is increased by 30% for kill or assist. And if a marked target dies, the enemy god closest to Kali becomes marked. If Kali is killed by an enemy god, she may choose a new target. So, her one is called Nimble Strike. We max this last. It's basically a jump, and which does damage in an area, and also Kali heals for 20%. Of her missing health. Since there are no benefits except for the damage to go up, And also the cooldown isn't going down. This will be maxed last, since it's a 20% missing health heal every time you're using it. This we will be maxing first, Lash. The Lion Throw damage ability, you can change the shape a little bit. As you can see, you have three blades crossing like in the middle. And can throw it like this. And as you can see, it applies, it does an initial hit for some damage, and then it does bleed damage for every half a second, so a total of 6 ticks plus the initial hit. So technically 7 hits in total. And Kali also gains a physical lifesteal against targets affected by the bleed effect. This is, pull the mouse completely back for a point blank hit, then you get to hit all three blades on a single target. Basically you need to hit it with the small target, target area. This is the point where the three blades converge. Like this, that would make all three blades hit. Or maybe not only two, should actually be three blades, but okay, fine. Where is it? Am I reading this correct? No, I always thought it were three blades, but no, this is actually just really three blades. The other thing here is only the target indicator, so you're throwing three blades, they converge at some point. This way you can shoot it straight away from him, so make sure you hit it really with the center. Something like this. That's pretty good one, so you don't have to build lifesteal, you're just using this ability, and at the max rank you have 5% physical lifesteal. This is also helpful in the early game when you're jungling against camps to heal up quickly again, which gives her some great sustain in the jungle. And also helps, of course, clearing the camp faster. Since this does quite some damage, even in the early game, that helps you clearing the camps. The next spell is called Incense. It's ground target ability. She hurls her incense at her feet, exploding it. Enemies hit or stunned for 1 second, and Kali also gains a physical power bonus buff for at max rank 8 seconds, and this is 50 physical power, so max this ability second. And I would say her ultimate destruction makes her the true late game monster. She becomes an unstoppable force of destruction, creating a damage aura around her, which takes damage. In the late at max rank, it lasts 4.5 seconds, and during this time, she can be reduced to 1 health, but she can't die. So you have practically 4.5 seconds of God mode. Of course, you can be CC'd, but you're immune to knock-up, slow effects, and also protected from roots. But you can still be stunned. If you're stunned, then you miss the opportunity to practically do something. The stun is the only thing that can stop you. Kali is under 15% health of her total health, and at the end of the duration she will heal to 15% health. So so if something goes wrong, you're not completely out of the window, you still have a sliver of health left, and that can get you back into Yeah, the, maybe that can get you out of the sticky situation you might be in, but not necessarily. So other than that, build-wise, I think you should always have kin size in your build. They should have one of these movement, one of these movement attribute items. Just pick one. Aston Katana is nice. I would recommend it, so you can stick like glue to your targets. Then you can think about it. Yeah, Serrated Edge. It's pretty good as well. Reduce the cooldowns on your abilities a little bit. Have more ultimate casts, more incenses, and probably also more jumps and more lash. You might need a protection shred as well. Could get this one maybe. They have here 20%, I won't need that, but you could get the Lantern's Bow if you want. A Crusher. That's something you would sell in the late game, but that might work too. Jesus Christ. Ah, we changed. We changed the teams again, so. What else could you pick up? Maybe even one defense item. Talisman of Energy if you want. It's great for chasing once the passive is up. But I don't have to. There's maybe also other stuff. Madras Cloak, not so much. Maybe Spirit Rope could work as well. Or if you're completely confident you don't die, which you shouldn't. Maybe get an RZ for extra boxing capability. It's really nice. You need to box the enemy ADC or another assassin. Or you can also go maybe Odysseus Bow. That adds also a lot of DPS, so you gotta check. I would say the only two core items are the Hasten Katana and the Kin Size. And everything else is completely up to you, whatever you want to build. And yeah, if you get ahead on her with a quick auto attack chain, you can, pretty much, you can one-on-one a lot of gods when your ultimate is up and you avoid stuns. And in the late game, you're like an unstoppable force. Unless you're stunned. Stuns are your only issue. And yeah, that's all about her abilities, and I would say we're queuing up, and let's see how she does in the gameplay situation. Right, let's play Kali. Kali is like a complete late game monster. People hate and like, depends on whose team it is and it performs good. I don't know, maybe probably won't do good, probably could go south this game, I don't know. Where Kali excels at, she has a super fast attack chain. She makes incredible good use of attack speed proc items like Kin Size. and a couple other stuff. She has a little bit of lifesteal in her kit. Her ultimate is great. You have to shut down her with CC while she's an ultimate. And is quite strong, let's just say. I would say four or five item Kali is no joke at all. You are not going to have a good time. Since she will just she will basically just take you out. Right, enemy team has two assassins. I intend to haunt Yao Kuang to the show up. I will try to kill him. Let's go Mannequin Scepter, and I think I need an Azzy here, maybe. Yeah, let's go Azzy, because I'm not absolutely sure if I can box him that good in the early or in the late game. Maybe we also rush. Morgan, take the red buff for Odin. Attack the minions. All right, I wouldn't have beat that, but if you want to beat it. I really had this Morgan. What? Okay, I take it.
Okay, literally all of my teammates are trolls.
Basically, Thanatos died to my lash somehow. It's ticking damage. I can change the throw radius a little bit. I have no idea. And I also need to check if Aokwang can ult me while I have my ult active. I'm not sure about that. I personally believe he can. We got that fella. So attack swing progression. 100%, 50-50, plus also 50.
Dude, that guy is literally a bot.
Yeah, of course.
I'm just trolling.
I also skilled the wrong ability. We'll be going Hasten Katana over here. Let's go for Thanatos. We have extra penetration against the targets we pick in Fountain. Oh, this is amazing because we are healing back to full. Let's go, baby. Please, please, please walk out. Right, needs 300 more gold for the Hasten Katana. Yeah, want Golden Blade? Probably not.
Oh my god, get far, baby.
I was reading chat.
Yeah, okay. There's a limit to what we can do without the ultimate. So, Akuang. Sort of my special friend in this match. Let's get a few camps here. Let's move out real quick. But I still think I need to get an RC in order to box him. I need to watch the backline here a little bit. Here we have him. I will definitely get an Ozzy here. Actually, I'm just waiting for this AO fella. Might as well the Thanatos, sure. Just...
An enemy has been slain. An ally has been slain.
That's Huckless crap. Okay, we need an RC definitely. But like I said, this is how he's wonderful. This is basically how he shot Carly down. You used to see her. Alright, let's pick up our RC. I'm not even sure what else we could get, maybe crit. Some sort. Huh?
Poggers.
Yeah, where's Thanatos? Alright, he won't make it.
That guy is literally a boss.
My attack speed, just not sure what exactly.
It's your job not to die.
What in the world? Let's go crit. It's by 2 crit items. I'm pretty sure we can get. We'll be buying Poison Storm.
Attack completed.
I'm not sure I can. Take it. I don't need a blue buff. And the other problem is,
okay, literally all of my teammates are trolls.
Fight me.
That was nuts.
Minions have reached your fortune.
Poggers.
That's dubbed, baby. An enemy has been slain.
Just a few cuts and bruises. Windyman and the last one will be pretty much, Poison Star.
Jeffrey, I'm bragging.
You're kidding me? Yep. What? Go Poison Storm. For crying out loud. That's why the 8-pounded shuriken, I'm sure we could have bought something better, but crit is just fine as well. Now we have ultimate run fast enough. Build a witch blade or something. Anyways, attack speed, attack speed. I have the poison stone now. Root him so I can get close, dude.
Okay, that is. Yeah!
An ally has returned.
I need to lifesteal over here a little bit. Mannequin Maze or Hidden Blade. Mannequin Maze. None of it at all. Wonderful. I have Kane. Nice. Yep, this was what the Azi was for. Really good for boxing. Stop dying, is it possible? Guess not. Yeah, this is wonderful. This is just completely garbage. To wait for this guy. Enemy has been slain. Do it! Like, pay attention or something. This can't be too hard. Here, please. Unnecessary. Man, move off the map with low HP. Really frustrating with these guys like that, but it's also but I gotta admit it's a bit harder to deal with two assassins, and then you have to keep track of the nice idea. What the hell?
Okay, literally all of my teammates are trolls. That's too bad.
Alright, that was the Kali guide. Hope you enjoyed it. Really insane good assassin when she gets online. CC is still one of her bane, like all assassins, but other than that, really great gods and tons of fun. See you next time.